kolme, kaksi, yksi, aja! Yksi, aja! Aja!
Okay. Gearbox day, manual 5 speed is going out. That tiny video 4. Drive shaft pin already came out. Okay. This is a result of broken dipstick fallen off inside the gearbox. So I think it shreds also the input shaft oil seal, and it's leaking badly. Oil. Okay. Long sub out. Everything disconnect. Clutch lever semua habis. So only left 6 volt subframe for transmission. And we'll see. One man. Is it possible? Okay. It's delivering. Yes. The book is out. Gone, super thin, full of burn marks and oil residue. Use replacement seems fine. Gearbox. Let's see inside here. Doesn't look too bad. Definitely needs proper cleaning. Ah, disgusting. Lots of leaking oil. So, it's night time. So, continue tomorrow. This ratchet strap. Ratchet strap for tilting the engine wheel. So, we can pull out the gearbox. Bye bye. Everything. Next day, everything heat up, degrease, and oh, it's really tough. I went through so many detergent and cleaner. 2 years of grime, CB grease, and everything. Oh. So, the flywheel looks good. Only I wish I can clean subframe later. Never mind. We'll go to the specialist degreaser on the wash. Lots of hyperagents. So a lot need to be done. See you next. Bye bye. Okay. Already cleaned up earlier today. Now, less slimy, less greasy. Onto the flywheel. Okay, final top.
Nak kena lagi ke mana ni?
Hah?
Nak kena lagi ke mana ni? Tak
lah, besok. Masuk ke? Wait. marking the bolt. I go a little bit extra. And the specs is 73 and I'm going 80. Just for extra measure, even after long flight. After putting thread lock. So, just to be safe, just to be safe. I don't want to do this gearbox drop anywhere soon. At least for another 5 years maybe. Or 10. I prefer analog torque wrench over the digital one. This one provide a better tactile feedback. The click 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 click, you don't have that same feedback from the digital one. And you have to watch readout and this analog. You don't need to look at it. That's what I feel and the sound. Super easy. Yet for the clutch time, we need to ensure the pilot bearing goes in properly. And this 22mm socket fits very nicely with some clearance for this pilot bearing. No worries of this getting stuck. And I'm coming at a weird angle, so that's fine. I need to lay on my back. Okay, I'm back. See this bag? Okay. Guess who's back? 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 Just use this cutout inside the glass housing to fill and center. better position of the clutch. Still center again, shove in normal socket and put through. Yes, dead on. Okay, I'm back. We smaller top wrench, 1/4 inch, and 2-piece adapter for 1/2 inch. My special lock tool for the flywheel. Click, click, click. My special lock tool device, flywheel locking tool. Any small bolt, box socket, shove it in it, and it will start on the starter disc. Just like that. I even did the same while doing the timing belt chop. Okay, then we continue tomorrow for the gearbox reinstall ceremony. Bye bye. Okay, time to install the mounts. I already transfer the speed sensor and reverse also neutral. So let's proceed and I'll go to time lapse. Baby, you give me
giving me wind and rain. You're some kind of butterfly. Baby, you get me feel lighter. You whip up my appetite. Don't leave me here high and dry.
Kotor, dirty, full of dust.
First drive after the gearbox and bunch of other stuff.